हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी दी वन इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक और बेसिक टॉपिक ऑफ इम्यूनोलॉजी एंड द नेम ऑफ दैट टॉपिक इज हिमेटोपोएसिस। सो दिस टॉपिक इट इज़ वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर दोज स्टूडेंट्स हु आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर CSIR NET exams as well as for MSc entrance exams in microbiology and biotechnology, and at the same time this topic is important for second year and third year microbiology students of different universities. So here let's start about the hematopoiesis. So in this topic we are going to see about the definition of hematopoiesis, then anatomy of hematopoiesis, then we will see the cellular pathways of hematopoiesis, specific differentiation pathways, hematopoietic growth factors, and lastly we will see the formation of blood cells. So the definition of hematopoiesis is, hematopoiesis, it is the formation or production of red blood cells, white blood cells and platelets, or which are also called as thrombocytes. In short, hematopoiesis, it is nothing but the formation of all types of blood cells. So this is anatomy of hematopoiesis. So the next one is here, the cellular pathways of hematopoiesis. See, the overall cellular organization of hematopoiesis, it includes stem cells. In further, there are two different types of stem cells. One is totipotent stem cells and second one is multipotent stem cells. Then another one, progenitor cells, precursor cells and effector cells. So the first we will see about the stem cells, and in that we will see totipotent stem cells, or which are also called as the godfather cells. These cells have the unlimited self-renewal. Then these totipotent cells, stem cells, they have unlimited differentiation. That means they can give rise to any cellular element. Then they are present in bone marrow in small numbers. These are highly resistant to chemotherapy. They reside primarily in bone marrow, and small numbers of these totipotent stem cells, they circulate in blood. They have the surface antigen called as CD34+. That CD, it stands for cluster of differentiation. And these totipotent stem cells, morphologically they looks like small lymphocytes, and the dysfunction of these totipotent stem cells, it can lead to the aplastic anemia or certain types of leukemia. Then the second one is here, that is called as multipotential stem cells, and these includes lymphoid stem cells and myeloid stem cells. So these multipotent stem cells, they derived from the totipotent stem cells. They are capable of extended self-renewal. They are also capable of extended differentiation. For example, these lymphoid stem cells or lymphoid multipotent stem cells, they can give rise to all categories of mature lymphocytes. And these myeloid stem cells, they can give rise to red cells, granulocytes, monocytes and platelets. So these lymphoid stem cells, they can give rise to so-called lymphoproliferative malignancies, such as acute lymphocytic leukemia, which is a one type of blood cancer we can see here. And these myeloid stem cells, they can give rise to so-called myeloproliferative malignancies, such as acute myeloid leukemia. So this next one is here, that is the progenitor cells or the colony forming units. So these progenitor cells, these are derived from multipotent stem cells. They are capable of limited self-renewal. They are capable of limited differentiation. And these colony forming unit, that is granulocyte, erythrocyte, macrophage and megakaryocytes. So these colony forming units, megakaryocytes, erythrocytes, then colony forming units, granulocytes and monocytes, colony forming units, granulocytes. So these cells, these are responsive. So here these responsive to these progenitor cells, these are responsive to hematopoietic growth factors, for example erythropoietin, which stimulates colony forming in its erythrocyte. Then granulocytes or CSF stimulates these CFU, GM and GCSF stimulates that colony forming units granulocytes. So they expresses differentiation antigens, that is surface proteins such as CD19 B lymphocytes. The next one here, precursor cells, that is blast cells and their progeny. So first, morphologically these are identifiable cells, and that includes erythroblast, that is red cells, myeloblast, granulocytes, monoblast, monocytes, and lymphoblast, lymphocytes, and megakaryoblast, platelets. So these are the precursors for the mature cells here. For example, as I told here, erythroblast, these are precursors for the red cells and like that. And they have little, if any, self-renewal. Then mature effector cells. So these includes red cells, which carry oxygen, carbon dioxide, and the lifespan of these red cells is 120 days. Then neutrophils, which perform phagocytosis and killing of pathogens or antigens. Then monocytes, which also performs phagocytosis, killing of antigens, and they are also involved in presentation of antigens. Then lymphocytes, they identify the self as a self or non-self. And platelets, they are involved in hemostasis or the blood clotting, that is thrombocytes. See, this is the diagram of hematopoiesis here. So this is a common myeloid progenitor, and this is the common lymphoid progenitor, and they all, both of these cells, they are derived from the hematopoietic stem cells. Then these common myeloid progenitor cells, they get converted into granulocyte monocyte progenitor, then eosinophil basophil progenitor, and megakaryocyte erythrocyte progenitor. Then see, this is about the, that is the progenitor cells here. All these are the progenitor cells here. Then later on, these are the precursor cells, which includes promyelocyte, and here which leads to the myelocyte. Then myelocyte leads to, that is, motamyelocytes, then band, and finally they leads to the cells which are called as segmented neutrophils. Then monoblast leads to the promonocyte, and finally they leads to the monocyte. Okay, then eosinophil, and finally these monocytes, they lead to the macrophages. Then eosinophil basophil progenitor cells, that includes myeloblast, and that is also myeloblast here. Then promomyelocyte, then eosinophilic myelocyte, then eosinophilic metamyelocytes, eosinophilic band cells, and finally eosinophils. Then these promyelocytes, basophilic myelocytes, basophilic motamyelocytes, then basophilic band, and finally basophil. And then here that megakaryocytes, erythrocyte progenitor cells, that finally leads to the erythrocytes and platelets. And here that common lymphoid progenitor cells, they produces dendritic cells, pre-B cells, pre-T cells, and natural killer cells. Then these pre-B cells, they produces B lymphocytes and plasma cells later on. And the T lymphocyte produces T lymphocytes. So here we have seen about the hematopoietic diagram. In next lecture, we will see about the next point, and that is about the specific differentiation pathways. Thank you.